It's not a day-day-day soundtrack. You know, it's not a nefarious group of men. It's not a cartel. And it's not related to Jewish thinking. You know, you would like to think that, but it's not. It's not that easy. It's an interest. It's an entity. You know, the Germans made this big mistake of blaming the Jewish bankers too, and it cost them the war. But really, it goes much deeper than that. But I would say that no one's actually innocent here at all, is there? But it's something much more personal, different than that, something deeper that you sense it by its activity. You see, it's throwing all the curtain rods and all the hijack and all the county clerks and all the tow truck extra iron and it's throwing the spare tires into the selection so bad because it has to win the selection. Okay? And that's what you start noticing, these zombie TV hosts just going, just glaring to the screen all of the way and looking like they're really talking some noise. They're reading the telephone from them. I've never seen Belsky like that before. Robotic hate like that coming out of Belsky is very unusual. Ali Belsky, it's very unusual to see him, a robotic, overweight, fat turd like that. And that's all I can describe it right now. I just watched his show for the first time in 20 years, and he's just got spittle all over his mouth. He's living in that New York City and land of hate. 0 hours coming. In that place. Let's just let it go. All false is better. Not worth it. Don't ruin your celebration about the NFL being back. Let it go. Don't worry about it. Where else should go? And he had studied religion in college and he studied communication in college. And he was one of the best and brightest. And they told him to back off his bigotry. Because around the year 2000, 2001, Belsky was the number one guy on the screen telling us that the end was coming. He could make a very strong point for it. And he got too radical, and they told Belsky to back off. So, but he got a career out of it, though. Yeah. He's not always right.